Click on this subscribe button and the bell icon so that you do not miss out on any of my future videos. Stay happy, stay healthy.
Hi friends, welcome back to this episode at Pep Talk with Neelam, and today I have something really serious to talk about. Swine flu is spreading like crazy throughout India, and most of somebody or the other known or unknown to us is hospitalized because of swine flu. So I'm dividing this episode into three segments. The first segment will be talking about all the symptoms that show that we might be having swine flu. My second part will be telling you all about the different kinds of home remedies which you can do and get 100% results for swine flu. And number three are the prevention measures. Let's get started. Swine flu is basically a very rapid spreading contamination which is an airborne, and you might even not know that you have already come into contact with a person who is already a carrier of the virus and you might be a sufferer. So it begins with a flu, that is a fever, which within 12 to 24 hours reaches to like 104 degrees even, and that is followed by quick chills. So there's fever and there's quick chills. The third symptom that you might have is a stubborn coughing, which will bother you at night for sure. That coughing is non-stop, and if it is not treated for like 2 to 3 days, since it is a respiratory disorder, it might even take you to have pneumonia. The fourth symptom that will be visible to you are swollen glands. The glands under your neck and under your armpits will be painful and tender to touch. That is because they are working continuously to fight with the virus present. And there is of course nausea and vomiting. Within 12 to 24 hours it might start. So all these are the symptoms which will indicate that you are suffering from swine flu. So let's come to the next part, that is the home remedies which will prevent you from H1N1, that is the swine flu. Giloy. Yes, we all have heard this name from Baba Ramdev, and we can now see giloy tablets, dried giloy leaves, dried giloy stalks, and most of the people even have now started planting this tree willingly into their houses because they know that this is like the mother of all antibiotics that you can possibly have. So when you want to consume giloy, the stalk is the portion which you want to use, not the leaves. And it's bitter, but trust me, it works wonders for any kind of inflammation, infections, virus, any kind of a bad thing happening to your body. So the first home remedy is the three basic things which help your body to make your immune system stronger: giloy, tulsi, and aloe vera. And of course, I believe that all of us should be having these plants into our homes. On the side, you can also have a kadha prepared. A kadha is something like a hot tea which is mixed with herbs, a lot of bitter herbs, and of course if you want to have a sweet taste, you can add 1 teaspoon of honey to it. So the recipe for this bitter tea, I would say, is like 1 or 2 grams of haldi, that is turmeric powder. To it, you'll add like 5 to 7 cloves, that is long, 5 se 7 long. And again, to it, you might add 3 to 4 kali mirch, that is black peppercorns. Mix them up all together and give them a good boil until the quantity of 1 glass of water reduces to half. Drink this mixture and it is definitely going to cure your H1N1 symptoms. Also, I would request you all not to forget to have lots of water, because you all will be nauseated, you all will be vomiting, and of course there is a widespread infection in your body and you want to flush that out through your kidneys as well. So drink lots and lots of water. Let's come to the third part of our today's talk, the prevention measures. First of all, if you are a carrier of swine flu, make sure that you are coming with least number possible of people in touch. Make sure that you are not moving out of your house for at least 7 days after even you've recovered. Number two, avoid going out to public places like malls, movie theaters, etc., where there's a very big chance of spreading swine flu. Number three, since these days the swine flu is at a rapid flow in the cities, I would request please avoid doing handshakes with any people. Our namaste is a lot more better. Number four, Make sure that at least thrice a day you wash your hands with a good sanitizer or an antiseptic soap, and along your face also should be washed frequently. Number 5. If possible, buy an alcohol gel based hand sanitizer or a hand wash, because alcohol kills germs far more better than the ordinary soaps. So that's all, guys. I hope this episode is helpful to you, and I hope that you make sure to forward this episode to as many contacts as you have, because I have gathered this information through some research here and there, and it is a useful information because it has been tried and tested. So this bitter tea or kadha is a very useful recipe to cure H1N1 symptoms. If you know someone who is ill or who is currently showing symptoms, make sure that you share the video to as many contacts as possible. And if you like my this video, do not forget to give me a big thumbs up and share it on your Facebook, WhatsApp. Let's make this video viral. Until next time, take care. Bye.